want another love, another love. Oh, my tears be used all on another love, another love. Oh, my tears be used all on another love, another love. Oh, my tears be used all.
Hey you guys, what's up? How's it going? So today's video is going to be another talk through makeup type of video. And I did one of these about 2 weeks ago when it was like a back to school, no makeup, makeup looks. But I got really good feedback on the whole like talk through makeup video thing, so I thought that I would do another one. And if this is your first time coming across my channel, I don't normally film in this setting. It's just because when I film makeup videos, it is so much easier to actually film in front of a mirror. And I've been really enjoying this more casual thing. I will be doing more like get ready with me's with more music and more editing and a prettier location and stuff like that. I just also want to continue to do these talk through videos in my bathroom. And the drink of choice today is a cinnamon latte. Guys, I'm filming this on September 1st, and that means you're allowed to get cinnamon lattes now. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with priming, and I'm currently using the Shiseido Refining Makeup Primer. My necklace just came apart. It came from an Asian wholesale site, and it's very hit and miss with those kind of stuff. There's no clasp, so it just kind of like hangs like this, but the string keeps coming out of the circle, so I don't know, guys. Tell me in the comments down below, at what time period does the necklace fall off? And now I'm going to be going in with the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion in Original. And I find that whenever I put primer on my face just goes like really red. Okay, so for this fall everyday makeup look, I'm going to be keeping the eyeshadow really simple because I just want to do like an sort of intense eyeliner look. Alright, so I'm going to be taking my Naked 3 palette and I'm going to be using the shade Strange all over my eyelid. And it's rare if I ever put white on my eyelids, like I'll always do a champagne, but I just feel like for this look, white is going to look the best. And I'm also taking that up all the way to my brow bone. The hot faces I pull when I'm putting on eyeshadow, for real guys, like it is hard to look cute when you're putting on your makeup on camera, like it is tough, for real. Okay, perfect. Now that we're even paler than we were before, I'm going to be taking the shade Dust and putting that in my inner corners. And oh my goodness, I love this shade for my inner corners. It is by far my favorite. And yes, this shade kind of has a lot of fallout and stuff like that, but I don't know, I really love it. And it's an amazing shade to put on the center of your lid if you wet your brush when you're like going out. So you can have like all those kind of dark blended eyeshadows, and then you wet your brush, you use Dust and put it on the center, and it will just be like that pop of gorgeous shimmery champagne as opposed to just kind of like a light wash of champagne. Alright, and for my eyeliner, I'm going to be using the Super Lino Duo Precision by L'Oreal. And this is a really good eyeliner. I haven't used it in a long time, but the other day I pulled it out. And I feel like if an eyeliner is getting really dry, if you don't use it for a little bit, like it can get better. You know what I mean? So that's what happened with this one. So there's one side done. Let's try to do the same thing on the other side. Sorry, I had to go off camera to finish that, but yeah guys, it's a very intense eyeliner look. But I think that this look is really, really, really nice for fall. So now I'm going to be taking the Make Up Forever Smoky Extravagant Mascara. Alright, so now that the eyes are done, I'm going to be moving on to foundation. And I'm going to be taking the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Foundation, and I've been using this every single day for probably a couple months now. And I do really like this foundation, and I wanted to ask you guys this question, but I feel like I can love a foundation, and then after continual use for a few months, it just doesn't look the same on me. I don't know if it's the fact that like my skin is getting used to it, or my perception of the foundation is changing because I wear it every single day, or what it is, or if maybe my skin just changes slightly every couple months. But I find that this happens quite frequently, and a lot of the times I'll stop using the foundation for a little bit and then I'll come back to it like a month later and then I'll really like it again. Do you know what I'm saying? And I definitely love this foundation. I 110,000,000,000% recommend it. I think it's just like my skin is getting drier recently. And I think it's because I would take off my makeup with coconut oil, but my apartment is so hot that any coconut oil just melt if I have it in a cupboard. So what I've been doing is I've been keeping the coconut oil in the fridge. So when it's in the fridge, it's just more work to get the coconut oil, like break it down with a fork or something like that, and then bring it with me to take off my makeup. Like I like just leaving it in a drawer and doing it right there, you know what I mean? So it's a little bit more work, so I haven't been doing that, and I've actually been using makeup remover wipes again, so I think that that is kind of drying out my skin. So yeah, just some fun facts. And I'm also doing flamingo pose again, and shout out to a person, I can't remember what video it was, but I had my hand up on a wall and someone was like, she's definitely doing flamingo pose. So shout out to that person for recognizing the flamingo pose. So I did a collab a couple months ago and it was an iPhone life hacks video. And recently it's getting a lot of views because I did a collab with Keep Calm and Blush on that video, and her video is going, I think I'd use the word viral, like it's insane. I think she's up to like 600,000 views right now, which is really crazy. So a lot of her viewers are coming over to my channel. And on that video, my number was shown by accident, and I didn't really think that it was that big of a deal when it happened because I didn't think that that many people would message me or call me. And before, it was totally bearable and I would actually like have conversations with people and stuff like that because I really wanted to be nice, and it means so much to me that you guys watch my videos and stuff like that, and it's nice to get to know you guys, so it didn't matter to me. So recently, since this video is getting more views, it's just been very overwhelming and I cannot keep up with it whatsoever. Like I might have to change my number, and I'm really sorry guys, but like my necklace is open again. Just going to have to take it off. Yeah, so what I'm saying is I'm really, really sorry guys, but like it's getting to the point where it's just really overwhelming for me. I'm getting like 20 texts a day from unidentified numbers and stuff like that, and it's just getting really overwhelming and I might have to change my number. So yeah, if you are one of those people who is messaging me and I haven't messaged back, it's not because I'm trying to ignore you, it's just the fact that I have so many. Yeah, I just kind of wanted to say that in a video. There's been a few people who were getting mad at me because I wasn't answering them. And guys, it seriously is not because I'm ignoring people or whatever, you know what I mean? And then I'm getting a lot of calls as well, and I answered a couple calls, and it's so funny because I would answer it and then they would say nothing, which I guess I totally understand because I'm thinking like, if there was someone who I watched their videos and I was calling them or something like that and they answered the phone, like I probably wouldn't know what to say. I'd probably say nothing too, but it's just really ironic that the video where my number is accidentally released is a video that's doing really well. It's like, why did that happen? But I mean, like, I'm not a crazy big YouTuber or anything like that, so I seriously never thought it was like that big of a deal. Yeah, so if you come across that video, what I'm saying is, I guess, like, please refrain from contacting me just because it's getting like way too much. But I definitely love you guys. Like I communicate with you guys all the time on like Instagram and Twitter and Snapchat and stuff like that. But yeah, I just kind of wanted to talk about that in a video. So also later today I'm going to be filming another video and I'm going to be talking about diet and acne, so different kinds of food groups and how they impact acne and stuff like that. And I was doing some research last night, so I wrote down all my points. So I'm going to be doing that video today, and I want to continue to do acne videos and stuff like that. I feel like there's not a whole lot of topics, but if you're creative you can kind of, I guess, like create topics and stuff like that. But I know that that's how a lot of you guys found me in the first place, so I definitely want to continue to do more acne videos. So next I'm going to be taking the NYX Above and Beyond Full Coverage Concealer, and I would definitely recommend like the MAC Pro Longwear under your eyes. It's the best concealer ever, but I only use it when I'm going out or if I just want to look really good on a day or something like that. I don't know why, I should probably use it every day if it's my favorite concealer, but I end up using this, which I'm not like a huge fan of. I don't know. Do you know what I mean though? Like some makeup products that are just more expensive, like you want to save them for special occasions. And I'm also going to be using this concealer for blemishes, which I think actually it works better on blemishes just because it's a wax consistency. Alright, and for my powder, I'm going to be using the, there's no wording on this anymore because I've had it for a while, but it's the, what is this? Seriously, what is this? It's a Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. I was thinking of a makeup company that started with an R, and I was thinking like Revlon, no. I think there's like another drugstore one that starts with an R, is there? I can't remember, but. Like, have you guys ever played a game where you're in a circle and there's like a letter or whatever, and there's a category, so say like dog breeds, and you have to go like A, B, C, D around the circle. And I love it when someone says like makeup companies, because I'm like, yes, I got this. All right, so I'm gonna be using the It Cosmetics Live Love Laugh Vitality Disc, and it has a blush, a bronzer, and a highlight, but I'm not going to be using a blush today because I just kind of feel like it would be a little bit intense because I have the intense eyeliner. I'm just going to be taking this bronzer on a kind of bigger, flat, fluffy, not flat, but just fluffy brush. So I'm not going to be contouring, I'm just going to be warming up the face. By the way, guys, I'm also going to be doing a fall lookbook video because I did that back to school outfit idea video and I got like really good feedback on that video, so I definitely want to do more videos like that. And for highlighter, I'm just going to be taking the highlighter from that palette. I need to start using highlighters like this one because my Hourglass Ambient Lighting palette, the highlighter is just going. It is just going. This highlighter is very pretty. I feel like it is actually quite intense, so this is a nice palette. And now for eyebrows, and I'm doing like this weird order, but I'm taking the It Cosmetics Brow Powder, and it's the Universal Eyebrow Pencil. So I'm just gonna be taking the brush end and going through my eyebrows. And then the wax end to fill them in. Whenever I put on foundation, I feel like it takes color away from the eyebrows, so I definitely like to go over it again. All right, so I really wanted to use Kinda Sexy by MAC for this look, but I could not find it. So I picked up May Bills Be Paid by The Balm. That's literally what it is called. May Bills Be Paid. And this is definitely in the same color family as Kinda Sexy by MAC. So it's just kind of like that nude brown color. I find it so funny how nude browns are now a thing. Well, they've been a thing for a long time now, but like, I feel like that was a universally hated color that no one would wear before. This one almost looks a little bit gray as well. That's actually really good for this look though. Holy crap, guys, this is such like a 90s fall look and almost grungy. I wasn't even like really going for that, but I think it looks good. All right, so that is everything for this video. Thank you guys so, so, so much for watching. So don't forget to subscribe if you aren't already so you can be notified when I upload more videos, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.